Hi friends, welcome back to VLSI Fab. Thank you for your continuous love and support towards VLSI Fab. And today I am going to make a video that is like completely related to BTech third year and fourth year students, and that is also applicable to MTech final year students. And today the video that I am going to make is like what to do just after completion of their BTech or MTech life. So guys, let's start the video without wasting time. When you are in the third year or final year of your BTech or final year of your MTech, so the first question that comes to your mind, that just after completion of your graduation or post graduation, what line to choose or what line to opt? So whenever you will consider all these things, you will consider future growth, scope, opportunity, and none other than money. Money is always a big factor while you will choosing your future aspect. So considering all these things, the answer to this question is VLSI. So please watch till the end. At the end of the video, you will come to know, like you will be able to decide why VLSI is far better than the other streams. So first of all, I will tell you what immediate options are available just after completion of your graduation or post-graduation.
After BTech, mainly these five options we have: core job, non-core job, government job, higher education, and own startup. So these things actually you know, but for clarity I have given this slide. So, and I have given a comparison between core job and versus other jobs. So in my next slide. But before going to next slide, we must understand that to get a core job, we must be technically strong. As you can see in the slide, for core job, I mentioned professional courses, but that is not applicable for tier 1 colleges such as IITs or NITs, because anyways they get placed through on campus in companies like Intel, Qualcomm, Nvidia with high package such as 17 LPA or 20 LPA like that. So for those who are not from tier 1 college, so companies expect them that they are at least previously did some internship. So if you want to know more about like how to apply and what are the chances to get VLSI jobs, and so all these things I have given in my VLSI Fab playlist. There is one playlist called Career Guidance, so you can watch those playlists and you can check it further.
After watching my previous slide, you must be confused what to do, what line to choose, correct? So friend, this is obvious, but before deciding anything, judge yourself what things you can capture first and what things you want to learn. So I have pointed out few of the things and I have summarized it from my point of view. So guys, please check it in the next slide.
So like every rose has its thorn, so in the same way, all job categories have their own advantage and disadvantages. So in the screen you can see that green tab means more and orange tab means comparatively low. So for you guys, I tried to find the weightage using some subcategories, and from this I can clearly say that core jobs are definitely running ahead in the race.
So till now we have seen core jobs are comparatively better than the government job or non-core jobs. So now we will check what kind of core jobs are available in the market.
Here you can see in electronics core jobs, mainly jobs are available in VLSI, microelectronics, embedded, and a few companies from signal processing, communication, and control system domain. So if I start with signal processing jobs, as I already mentioned, it cannot stand with its of its own. So DSP applications are always embedded with other technology. So very few companies working solely on DSP applications. So likewise, those who will choose communication as their MTech branch, they will be left with very few options like Qualcomm or BSNL, but still company windows are less compared to embedded or VLSI. So now coming to the main point, who is having the most job opportunities in India as well as abroad? So tough fight between embedded and the VLSI. I won't go much details about what is embedded or what is VLSI. You can Google it. But I would like to mention few points so that it would be easier for you while choosing your career. See, the grass is always greener on the other side. Choose one because you like it and because you are good at it. Okay, so it's mostly about what gives you more chills. If you love reading about designing ICs, CPUs, SoCs, etc., go for VLSI design. If you are rather more focused on practical use of various SoCs and creating new invention based on already existing things, go for embedded systems. Both have lots of opportunities and pay fairly well, but VLSI comparatively more pay than embedded.
So guys, till now we have seen what are the jobs available after BTech and why government jobs are not preferable in case of core jobs and why VLSI is most preferable branch in core jobs. Guys, if you have decided the same, then please go through this and check out what profiles are there and what key skills are required. So guys, please check it out.
So VLSI is having mainly physical design, verification, RTL design, DFT and CAT profile. So in physical design companies, the recruiter expect little expertise from the candidate, so trained or interns are preferred. In the same way, to get into verification also, interns are preferred. If you want to know more how to apply for the jobs and how to apply for internship, please watch my career guidance playlist of VLSI Fab. And other than this, application engineer profile, product validation profile such as pre-validation, post-validation and some EDA tool management related profiles are there.
So guys, if you like this video and you want more this kind of videos, then please comment in the comment section and please like, share and subscribe for upcoming videos of VLSI Fab. Thank you for your love and support. VLSI Fab. Thank you.